and welcome to FilmFest on TV. I'm your host, Jessica Kogan-Hayes. This program is your window into the world of independent filmmaking. From the rising stars of tomorrow to the hardworking amateur filmmakers of today. They might be following their passion in search of a glittering career, or just want to share their hobby with you. Today we're delighted to present to you the feature film Out of Time by Harry Peaks and Gary Ward. Out of Time is set in Brighton, shot entirely on location. A policeman whose girlfriend has been kidnapped will do whatever it takes to get her back. The film was made on a micro-budget with no sponsors. Everyone involved in the production worked voluntarily, whether they be friends, family or strangers. Not only are we bringing you the feature film today, at the end of the show we'll have the short movie On Time, a prequel to the feature film. If you'd like more information on our filmmakers, please like our Facebook page or follow us on Twitter at FilmFestOnTV. If you're a filmmaker and would like to see your work featured on FilmFest, then get in touch with me, Jessica Kogan-Hayes, via jessica@thelatest.tv. We're now joined by Out of Time's directors, Harry Peaks and Gary Ward. Harry is a 19-year-old student from Brighton Film School, and Gary is Harry's stepfather, it's a hard one to say, and also producer of the film. He plays the leading role in this film, but will you be able to spot Harry? Let's watch the trailer first, and then we'll have a chat with both of them. Harry and Gary, thank you very much for coming in today and for bringing us your film. Got to say, I love the symmetry of your names.
Yeah.
That's rather wonderful.
Clash, isn't it?
Now, before we start talking about your film, which, again, I just can't believe that you made it for no money. It's so good. We'll talk about that later. Before we get to that, I want to know a little bit about your filmmaking background. How did you get into film? How did you decide this was the thing for you?
Well, me, it was mainly, I was into a lot of taking pictures and stuff, and then it just evolved into moving images, and that's when I realised that film was something I wanted to actually do. And then that's when I went into studying at City College, and that's where I built my knowledge in film and made a few projects, music videos and such. But then I decided I want to do something more than just making projects in college. Yeah. I was like, okay, I'm going to do something really big, and decided this is where this whole idea of this feature-length film came from.
But it's pretty huge, like for a side project, whilst you're still at college, to make a feature film, which most directors, you know, they're pleased if they manage to do that before they're 35. No, you really went for it. And dragged your stepfather in too. Now, I believe I've been told that you were not an actor before this role came along.
No, I've never done anything as such. I've always been a big movie buff, love my films, but it's something Harry said he wanted to do, so I offered to help and sort of a lot more involved than what I actually first intended to.
Yes, a lot more involved since you're in almost every frame.
Yeah, true.
And how did you convince him of this?
You was like, you know, you wanted to come up with an idea, you had an idea as well. So this idea, we just both got together and we just came up with this great idea and scripted it. And as it went along, it was a load of drafts obviously before. Mm. And then this idea just kept getting built on. Scene after scene, and then we added a few here, a few there. It was like, how can we make this longer? How can we make this more intense? And then that's when it just started, we just build it together.
But you've brought in a lot of other people as well, who I believe were giving their time for free.
We had to depend a lot on that. Sort of ringing in first friends and family. Harry knew a couple of people who'd done little bits of film work before, so we were quite lucky there to offer their time.
Of course, you're on a film course.
Yeah, and then we, in the end, I even found Big Pete. He was just someone I found on Facebook. He was a big guy, and I thought, yeah, he's perfect for a role in the film. And,
perfect for a character called Big Pete.
I messaged him on Facebook and asked him if he'd be willing to help. And he was great. Yeah, he was good, just for someone I didn't even know.
Well, that's incredible. The incredible kindness of strangers then.
Yeah, exactly.
Getting involved. Did you have issues, though, with people giving their time for free, then imagine dropping out?
Yeah, there was major, wasn't there?
A lot,
we had scenes where, like the running scene.
I wasn't even meant to be in that. Like, I was, you know, I wanted to stay out of the film in
general.
Yeah,
it's not a spoiler for the film, but just to say, be aware, at some point, Harry does pop up, running along.
It's a good scene.
Yeah, a friend let us down in the morning, and we literally had, because we knew it was going to be like an all day, that scene was, we was running from a long, it was 10 to 3 in the afternoon.
Yeah,
I think we were constantly running.
I hope you had a very good dinner.
Legs were killing for a whole week.
Yeah, it was killing, the legs were done. But yeah, so Harry had to drop in that day. And then there was the Beth as well.
And I hear this was quite a major casting change.
Yeah, it was. We did a couple of scenes, and then right near the end of when we needed to finish doing the scenes with her, she fell pregnant and was unable to continue with filming. So
yeah, can't really halfway through, she gets a bit pregnant, suddenly she's not. Well, there's a belly, no, there's
yeah,
not.
Yeah, exactly.
And she's a very major character.
Yeah, she is, yeah. So a friend of mine, Laura, who was actually originally the second choice anyway, it was between the two, yeah. And luckily she had the time to come and help, and she was great.
Yeah, she fit the part perfectly, yeah.
Reshoot everything.
Yeah, reshot the scenes we'd already done.
My goodness. But the idea of the film itself, so do you want to just explain a little bit about the plot without spoilers?
Oh, okay. The idea itself is, it's about, he's a cop and he's just a Brighton cop. She, obviously his girlfriend, goes missing, and he's left clueless to like where she's gone, and he gets this random call telling him to do certain things, and if he doesn't do it, she will be punished and you know, killed. So it's, you know, he's under time to do all these things that he's being told, otherwise consequences.
Under a lot of pressure. Yeah. What would you say were your influences in the film?
I think the main one was, because when I originally wrote it, the big one that was popping in was Die Hard with Vengeance, because in that film he has to get to certain places, and when I was thinking of ideas, that's one of the ideas that kept springing to my mind, the whole having to be somewhere by a certain point, and you have to do whatever it takes to get there by that time, and being on a timeline to do things, it's just always with a film, I find that can always push it along a lot.
Gives you some momentum to
and it's
storyline,
and plus with the audience it keeps them intrigued to what's going to happen. Is he going to get there in time?
Dun, dun, dun.
Yeah.
All right, we're about to start watching the film. Is there anything else you want the audience to know beforehand?
Well, I like the, within the film as well, talking about the idea, the character, you know, the way the character changes as well, which we really quite like, which is what we wanted to see. We wanted him to see him as this normal Brighton cop, and then see him slowly changing throughout the whole film. And he's just, you know, you don't see him the same way as you did at the start.
Yeah.
Which is what I was going for.
Well, fabulous. Yeah. Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, here is Out of Time. Hello again, Harry and Gary.
Hello.
I just love saying that, I'm sorry. Thank you very much for staying with us, for bringing us your film. Again, can we just say, no budget.
Yeah.
Amazing. I mean, what a storyline. The scenes involved in that and the shots. But I understand, Harry, that you're not actually interested in becoming a film director.
That is correct. I'm more the cinematographer behind the camera. I like to do all the shots. Like, I was... We both directed the film, kind of put our input, but I was mainly focused on my shots with the help of my friend Tom. Tom Francis, who was my second cameraman, who went to college with me as well. And then that's when we both helped each other out with this film.
Yeah. But so the aim of this film, obviously it's a wonderful thing to have, to go on to your career, you've got a bit of a calling card. You can make some fabulous showreel material out of this, but making it didn't sway you towards direction?
No, not at all. No, I've always had an eye for camera, really. So, it's never really been directing for me, but.
It's a very interesting thing to have made just as a side project. Was there anyone else he brought into the film who then discovered a real love for films and creating films that they've taken onwards?
It's probably me.
Yeah,
going to, going to act a bit more, Gary?
Yeah, it's probably me, actually.
Well, actually, we've interested a lot of people. All the people that have acted in it, they've been really, you know, they've been really intrigued to being our next film now. They're like, oh, when's this coming out? When you bring in another film, we want to be in it. We want to be part of it. And they're all
brilliant.
Yeah, they're all really.
And there's a few surprises actually in the film. The few people we sort of brought in, like for the extra scene, brought in a friend Tom Fox, who he'd never done acting before or anything. He was like a last minute. I got an idea to put in, and we discussed it, and we said, yeah, okay, we put this in. Got Tuesday, she came in, and she had done some acting work before, and we put them together. My friend Tom was really nervous, but the scene with them, they're the ones where I'm in the house, and they come in and I have to hide, and then I interrogate them in the bedroom with the knife in the leg.
Yeah.
And
that was probably my favourite scene in terms of shot types that I've done there, actually.
Ah.
I quite like that one.
Yeah.
I think if I was to put something in my show reel, that would be the scene I would like most.
Yeah, I like to say on camera I didn't hit a woman.
Okay. Okay, but you did hit the man?
No, obviously not.
No one actually got hit. We're okay. Yeah, it was cinematic magic.
Yeah, yeah, nothing was. That's one thing you have to make clear. Nothing was. No laws broken. The driving sequences were sped up on
camera. What about the
gunshots? Oh, that was something that's... I did in. Because I've edited the whole film myself as well. So not great only job. Did I film it, I sat in my bedroom, spent a lot of time on Adobe Premiere, just had the whole timeline out in front of me, editing away completely. And as for the gunshots, I used obviously Adobe After Effects, and I didn't have a clue what I was doing on that. And I basically just taught myself how to do it.
Amazing.
And I was just going through YouTube, watching loads of videos, and
YouTube videos
to teach me the way. So.
Fabulous. You managed to actually create very realistic bullet holes.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive.
Which,
that, yeah.
I mean, I was watching that for the first time and being like, okay, they say no budget, but really,
yeah.
Where's the explosives here? But that's very impressive to hear that you just did it in After Effects and editing.
It was after a few tries, though, because we tried it and then it didn't look real. We just kept going over and over in it and trying to make it look more real.
It's like the bit of fight sequence, isn't it? With Pete, when I shoot Pete after he's about to get me and I shoot him in the stomach. We did that twice. We actually did it with his top ripped, with some blood coming out, and then we did it without the top being ripped. And we wanted to try two different ways, didn't we? We wanted to see would it work, just him being shot with the blood coming out, or for Harry to do it on the editing suite. And the editing worked better, didn't it? Putting the bullet holes on him and doing it. So yeah, most of the special effects and everything's all been done on the. Editing genius. Yeah.
Which is fabulous. Have you discovered a new passion for editing?
Hard work.
Yeah, that's what I mean. It's not something I like doing. I'd rather find someone who can actually do better editing than I can myself. I like to get out and about. I hate sitting indoors in a computer.
Oh.
Just gets a bit tedious at times and stressful when it crashes every now and then, especially with an hour-long project and loads of files and hard drives getting full.
Now, next up, we're going to be watching a short film of yours, On Time, which is a sort of prequel, would we say?
Yeah, it was the original. Yeah, it was the original. Well, that was for your college, wasn't it?
That was the original college project that I was doing, that I did with my friend Tom as well. And then that's when we decided, you know, as I said, we want to make a bigger, better film. We just made that one afterwards, which went pretty well.
And Gary, did you get the acting bug from doing just this short film?
I think, a bit. I always wanted to. Always been a massive film buff, so. That was something I always wanted to do. I think every boy does, I think, growing up, wants to be in their own film, I think. It's every man's dream. But, we did help Harry with that, wrote him a little script for a short film, and then I sort of helped act in it. And you had your friend Jamie,
Jamie. He was in
Jamie Langlands, who's done.
He appears in, I've got to say, quite a few Brighton films.
Yes, he does.
Pretty much every indie film made in Brighton.
He's doing well, actually.
Yeah, definitely.
He's a good actor, he is. So we used him. And then again with Tom Francis, isn't it, who did the camera work with you.
Well, here we go. Here is On Time. We'll be chatting a little bit more about it after the film. That was On Time. Now, On Time was made before Out of Time, obviously. It's got to be very different making a short film and then a much, much longer film. It's a much bigger production. You're going outside, et cetera, et cetera. But was there anything that you learnt from making a short film that you really took forwards with you?
From the short film, it was in that one room all the time. And we were actually planning to get out. We wanted to get out the room a bit more and show it. Well, I was thinking of doing that, but we thought just keep it in that one room. Don't really show any of the outside, really. And it was easier to do, but then that's when I wanted to get out on the outside with the next film, but then that's when I came under a lot of problems. Yeah, filming all over different places, though. Yeah, it's a lot more harder.
Well, that's all right.
Yeah.
It was a lot quicker to film as well. Like one scene we could just do flat out, bang, 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 film. It was done, wasn't it?
Yeah.
But then did you find it a lot more enjoyable having the scope of a much larger film? Because you can really let your imagination run wild, within reason.
Yeah, actually. That was the fun part, wasn't it, with the big one?
Yeah, as I say, with the On Time. It was nice, though, because we was in one location. It was, you know, we could set up. We had like a little dolly track as well. We can move it around. Mm. It was nice. We had some nice, intense shots. Whereas with, Out of Time, it was kind of like, you know, shoot and run, you know, kind of on the move all the time. So
it's like the running scene. Tom Francis did a great job with the filming on that, because he had at one point we're sprinting and he's having to run with the camera on his shoulder, and then
not for the reverse shots,
he was then having to run with the camera backwards, sort of to hold.
That was a technique I was impressed with, actually. So. He was actually filming blind, you know, which was pretty. He just had it on a wire and he was just running backwards like that the whole time.
Oh,
he did a great job there with that. The running scene, like I say, that's my favourite.
Yeah.
And.
But is there anything other than kind of going outside the room and exploring the world that you've created a bit more? Is there anything that you would take from having learned from the feature film that you'd want to go back to On Time and change?
Oh. The sound was for you, isn't it?
Oh yeah, that was. I believe with the first one we had less equipment then. We used just little external mics on our DSLR cameras, which weren't that great. Whereas with Out of Time, we used a boom with a Rode on the end, so we had better sound equipment then. Whereas before we didn't.
And sound makes all the difference.
Oh, it really does.
All the difference.
Definitely.
Now, quickly tell me. What's the future for this father-son directing, acting team?
Well, I was thinking of next. Was looking into a horror film, weren't we?
Horror film, definitely.
Yeah. Ah. Looking at changing it up a bit more now. But
okay, so we'll be seeing you guys again at Halloween.
Yeah, I want to do a horror. Horror is another thing. You've got a short film you want to do, don't you?
Yeah, definitely.
And of course, you're only in your first year of the Brighton Film School.
Yeah.
And I'm keen to do an Out of Time too, but what's
your door? You just want to be in everything. You're just ready. If anyone's got a film they want to employ Gary, clearly, phone him. He wants to be there, which is fabulous.
Yeah.
Now, have you got any advice for young filmmakers or even just young people who'd like to get into the film industry?
I'd tell them to just get out there and make, you know, don't underestimate yourself. Just film what you can, and you know, even if you know your projects, you know, some bits you don't like, you know, don't think, oh, I can't do a feature length film or something, you know, because if you got, you know, as I'm 19 and I've got, you know, I feel great having
you get a feature film behind you.
You know,
it's okay.
It's, you know, don't underestimate yourself and don't ever quit on something.
Yeah.
You know, just stick at it and keep going for it. You know.
Now, here's a question that obviously you're going to be a little bit biased about. Would you say that a film education is important? Would you say going to a film school is important, or even just doing a university course about film? Or do you think you know, it's okay if you get to the third year of your math degree and you decide that actually film is where you want to go to. Do you think you need that education aspect, or do you think just getting hands-on and getting out there is enough?
No, I believe I'll need that education as well there, just so I have an insight of film itself and its backgrounds. And I need to know, you know, I need the history of how filmmakers, you know, how they filmed and all the shots that they did. And, you know, as I say, you know,
Thank you.
Don't want a degree rule. I've never known about that otherwise, but...
Well, I've got to say thank you so much to the two of you for coming in today and for bringing us both of your films.
Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
That's it for tonight's show. Thank you for watching, and I hope you've enjoyed it. Please do share your thoughts with me on Twitter by tweeting me directly at LatestJessica or using the hashtag FilmFestOnTV. Thanks again to filmmakers Harry Peakes and Gary Ward for bringing us the Brighton-based film Out of Time. If you would like more information, then check out his website, harrypeakes.com. And if you've missed any of tonight's film and would like to catch up, then please check our Facebook page for details of repeats. Equally, if you're a filmmaker and would like to see your work featured on FilmFest, then get in touch with me, Jessica Hogan-Hayes, by jessica@thelaters.tv. If you're sending me a film, then please include the title, runtime, a brief synopsis, and a link if it's available online. If you love films as much as I do, then you'll love our upcoming season. Each week, I will bring you independent films and documentaries and maybe sit down to chat with the professionals working in the industry or just starting out on a glittering career. Glitter. Watch out for our next episode as we're preparing a special show with Sundance film contestants. See you then.